Hello everyone and welcome to Canine Pack Leader Dog Training. My name is Nitesh and I wanted to share this video with all of you. It's a must watch for three important people. First is people who already have dogs into their life. Second is people who are planning to get a dog into their life or planning to adopt a dog into their life. And the third one is very much important, more important, which is people who are planning to gift dogs to their families or friends. Please watch this video, it's very much important. So guys, to begin with, last night you guys must have seen that I had posted a story on my Instagram page, rest in peace Kobe the German Shepherd. She was only 5 months old, guys. I just trained her for one class long time back, and after that there was no response from the owner, and which is completely fine for me. She passed away last night. I got a call from the owner, and then when I reached, she was no more. The doctor also declared her death. So they were not able to manage her properly, if you ask me. I'll be really honest. Both of them were working. They are working professionals. Husband works, wife works, and the dog is left behind alone. It's not something which is justified to the dog at the end. It's an animal. It's a life. It's not a toy. It's a responsibility, guys. So my suggestion to all of you would be, especially to the three category people, because I myself also, I have two dogs. One is a Labrador and the other is an English Retriever. I have taken both their responsibilities. So my request to all the people out there who are planning to get dogs, who are planning to adopt a dog, who already have dogs, or who are planning to gift a dog, first ask or know the other person whether they are capable enough of handling a dog or not. Second is, do they have that much of time, do they have that much of patience to handle a dog? Because the dog cannot speak, it will just do its own natural way of communication, which is through barking, lunging, and worst of the worst case, biting. You need to understand whether you are capable or competent enough to have a dog into your life. Do not get a dog into your life just because your neighbor has got it, or you feel that there is nothing to do in the lockdown, you're planning to get a dog. It won't be a good decision, guys. Have mercy on the dog is what I would say. Because dogs need commitment. They need exercise daily. They need good quality, especially breed dogs. I'm talking about breed dogs, not also strays. If you're planning to have a stray or you have a stray, they need food, they need supplements, they need proper vet visits on time, they need their vaccinations, annual vaccinations on time. They need to be handled properly, they need to be maintained properly to ensure that they live those many years which they're supposed to. Kobe passed away yesterday at the age of 5 months old. 5 months, guys, is not an age for a German Shepherd to pass away, which can easily live up to 15-16 years. Okay. So my suggestion and request to all of you guys would be that don't get a dog if you are a working professional. It doesn't make any sense. If you guys are busy, how will you give time to your dog? It's not justified at the end for both of you. If you really have that patience, if you really have people who can take care of a dog when you're not there, is when you can make a choice. But then if both of you or all the people are not there in a house, you cannot have a dog living by its own self, and then later on you blame the dog and say that the dog is a problem. Dogs are never a problem, guys. I have been dealing with, when I train dogs, I have seen multiple dogs of various categories, big, large, strays, breeds, every category of dog. It's not the dog always. It's maximum time the owner, 90%, 95% of the time is the owner's way of handling or managing the dog. It's very much important, guys. Most of us, or most of the people I have seen, they have got dogs, but they don't know what does a dog actually need. What is the instinctual need of a dog? They don't have time to go out for walks, but they want to have dogs like Labrador Retrievers, Golden Retrievers, German Shepherds, Siberian Huskies. All these dogs are working breed, guys. They are not someone who are meant to be kept into a house. You cannot have a dog, a high energy dog, into your house if you yourself are lethargic. If you're not active enough to have an active breed, you don't need to have an active breed. Go for a dog which is low in energy. But always make sure that you know that you'll be able to commit your 13, 14, 15 or 16 years to a dog's life. It's very much crucial, guys. It's a life at the end. You cannot say that just because you're busy, you have office, you are not taking your dogs out for a walk, or if you don't have time, you're not able to take her your dog to the vet. It's not justified at the end. So my request to you, all of you guys, would be, ask yourself, do we have the patience to have a dog in our life? Can we commit to walk our dogs 2 to 3 times a day? Can we feed them good food? Can we take them to vets as and when needed? Can we handle their expenses as and when needed? Because there are many sudden expenses also which come, guys. I deal with dogs, I have 2 dogs, and there are sudden expenses which do come. So ask yourself, if there are sudden expenses, do you have that much of capability to take care of the dog's expenses which arise suddenly? Because anything can happen at any point of time, guys. So you need to be prepared, because you're at the end taking the responsibility for a dog. It's a life at the end. So do not neglect it, and do not consider it as a toy. It's something which is not good, and it's something which is really not appreciated. Okay, I'm talking this because the experience which I have got yesterday specifically, it's very much sad, guys. It's very much sad. I had lifted her dead body, which is not a good thing, and I don't know if you guys must have experienced this as well, but it's a very bad experience. It's not something which you expect a 5 months old puppy to just pass out at such an early age. So guys, ask yourself, do you have the commitment? Do you have the time? Do you have the patience? Will you be able to commit 14, 15, 16 years of your life to a dog? Will you serve him? Will you take proper care of a dog? If the answer is yes, is only when you go for a dog. If no, I would say give it a second thought. Also, people who are planning to gift others a pet dog, please rethink or take this idea into consideration. Ask the person who you're supposed to, or whether they'll be able to commit to that dog's life. Because I see dog owners and I see dogs suffering directly and indirectly in multiple ways. Okay, so think about it, guys, and I request you guys to take my video seriously and think about it, because it's at the end a life. A dog is not a toy, it's a life. Thank you.